Cholinergic Uticaria is affecting nearly 250,000 people here in the US alone. It is clear to say that not everyone knows exactly what this disease is. Cholinergic Uticaria, also referred to as CU, affects nearly 0.05% of the people around the world. With very few people being affected, not many studies have been conducted to find out exactly what CU is. This discussion will not only focus on one part of the person's body, but the whole body and how it really is being affected. If you ever had an allergic reaction, you know it can be painful and sometimes irritating. CU is different from all other allergic reactions because the person infected is allergic to himself. How can this be? CU, also referred to as physical hives, are found to be triggered from almost anything that makes a person sweat. Many things have been found to be these triggers, but the most common things are things such as the sun, anxiety, and physical activity are all known causes of this. Once the individual has been exposed to the trigger, small red bumps, or hives, appear on the person's forearms, back, and chest. Recent studies have shown that this is caused by an allergic response of a certain cell. A neural receptor known as acetylcholine is overflowing cells known as mast cells. These cells are responsible for most allergic reactions in the body. Many might be wondering why these cells are being activated. Many studies have came to the conclusions that genetics is involved. The individual suffering from CU may be lacking a specific enzyme that is responsible for breaking down acetylcholine and stop the overflow. When your cell is activated, the release of many toxins that cause inflammation and the reason why these hives appear. You might be wondering if this can lead up to death and if it's contagious. CU is not contagious, and no studies have shown that they can lead up to death. The Journal of Dermatology and collaboration between scientists and doctors are looking for further answers on how to prevent and cure CU. These researchers include methods on medications that can treat CU and how we can prevent it before the person even knows it's there. As of now, no known medications have worked to suppress this from happening. Sweat therapy has helped many, but is only a temporary reliever. For further information, please download the case study. And from everyone here, this is Edgar saying goodbye, and please give this video a thumbs up.